There is a correlation between the position of the implant and the emergence profile, and the worst scenario is when the implant is very buccally positioned, giving the appearance of a very long tooth. It's in this case that the implant was not only very buccally positioned, also it was very deep. In a case like this, I make a provisional restoration, a screw into the implant, and we make two connective tissue grafts in two different surgeries, very thick ones, and through a tunnel technique. This is 3 weeks after treatment, during the healing. At the time of the delivery of the restoration, this is the result that is better than the starting point. But what is really nice about these connective tissue types is that over time they improve, and this is the result 1 year after treatment, and this is the result 4 years after treatment. The last P that I would like to share is our surgical protocols. In 95% of our cases, we do immediate placement of the implant, but only if the implant has primary stability and the head of the implant is in the correct 3D position. When the implant is unstable, we do regenerative procedures first. The immediate protocol has three different surgical differences. And after the extraction of the tooth and we place the implant, if the head of the implant is less than 2 millimeters from the buccal bone, we fill that gap with just a connective tissue graft. And afterwards, I place a Maryland bridge. If the head of the implant is more than 2 millimeters away from the buccal plate, we fill that gap with bone chips obtained from a sterile filter from the drilling of the implant. And afterwards, we place a connective tissue graft on top of that bone. But if the defect is even bigger, but still we can place the implant and it's a self-retained defect, we fill that gap with bone, we place a membrane, and after we remove the membrane, we place a connective tissue graft on top of that. Let me show you with a video some clinical cases as a summary of the protocols that I have talked to you. And of course, this is not possible without a teamwork. And I would like to thank also the University of Southern California, especially my directors, Dr. Chi, Dr. Donovan. Thank you to my kids that probably one day they will attend that university. And thank you all for your attention.
I don't know about you, but I was dancing over there on the side.
Thank you, Ava. That was a beautiful presentation.